Accurately estimating a job is paramount for any irrigation landscape contractor. Underbidding a system could mean lost profits, while overbidding means you might not get the job to begin with. One key factor in estimating is to know how many zones it will take to irrigate a property. To do this, you need three pieces of information. One is the area of the property that you're irrigating. The second one is the precipitation rate of the heads going into the property. And the last piece you need to know is how much water you have available at the source. There's a couple of ways to get the area of a property. One is for you to physically go out there and measure the property, but another way is for you to use websites like goilawn.com, who uses tools and satellite imagery to give you an accurate area calculation without you ever stepping foot out on the job site. The second piece of information you need is the precipitation rate of the heads you like to use. Now, thankfully, the manufacturers give us this information in their catalogs. So all you need to do is go inside, find the nozzle, and move across and find the precipitation rate for a given head spacing and pressure. Once you have the precipitation rate and the area, we can put it into a formula that will give us the total flow for that system. Once we have that value, we can divide it by the available water at the source, and that will tell us how many zones it will take to irrigate that property. Here's an example. The area of our property is 40,000 square feet. The precipitation rate of the head we're going to use is 0.5 inches per hour. So what you're going to do is take the 40,000 square feet, multiply it by the 0.5 inches per hour. You're going to take the result of that and divide it by 96.3. 96.3 is a conversion that will get our units into gallons per minute. When we do this math, the result will be 208 gallons per minute. The last bit of information we need is the available water at the source. In our example, we're going to have 18 gallons a minute. Now take the 208 total gallons a minute and divide it by the 18 gallons a minute of the source. And that will give us the total number of zones, which is 12. Now, that is our starting point. It's going to take a minimum of 12 zones to irrigate this property. And you'll need to make adjustments for your estimate based on microclimates and plant type. To learn more about estimating zones and other irrigation-related topics, attend one of our live seminars. For more information, visit us online at ewingirrigation.com.